We are broadcasting here at Feasterville, beautiful Feasterville, Pennsylvania. We are a little bit early behind the scenes for East Coast Derby Extravaganza 2012 edition. As you can see the track behind me, just minutes ago we had a referee clinic that was wrapping up. So a lot of action, a lot of excitement, but now it's just about the calm before the storm. We've got a couple of people joining us. We're going to get a little bit inside before we get started on our weekend. Joining us, we have Tank, we have John Koolaid Porter, and we have Brad Example. Gentlemen, I have a few questions. First question I have for you, Tank, is I need an ECDX game this weekend where an underdog is going to have the better chance to win. Who do you think?
I don't think they're going to win, but they definitely have a shot, Philly versus Texas. Philly, in the past, ECDX had been a very strong team. Last year, they went 0-2, losing to both Rose City and Gotham. So you know that this year, they're going to want to get back on the winning track, plus Texas having to come into Philadelphia and the whole travel schedule that goes with that of having to go from Austin to get here to Philadelphia. I still think Texas is going to get the W, but if there's a shot for an upset, it's there.
Excellent. Mr. Porter?
I would say that my underdog team is going to have to be the Arizona Roller Derby 10 City Terrors. You know, this is a team that's currently ranked number 10 out of the West, but in case you've missed the memo, they've added three all-star players, number 7 Hockey Honey from Ole, number 747 Joy Collision from Charm, and number 3 Animatrix, also out of Ole. This team has, you know, one of the original WFTDA members really have done nothing since 2006. They lost all of their games in 2008. They only won one in 2009. Since then, they've been mediocre at best, but all of a sudden, you take three very good skaters with a lot of tournament experience and put them on that team. I'll be very curious to see. They're skating against number 7 out of the East, Boston, Saturday at 4:30, and then number 4, Steel City, on Sunday. So two very, very good teams, but I'll be very curious to see how Arizona handles those challenges with their new players.
All right. And Brad, example?
Well, I can't argue too much with what Koolaid said, but I'd almost call Arizona not the underdog in those matches. I'd almost favor them to win. If this were last year, I'd say that the my choice for an underdog team right now actually is Montreal. I've seen Montreal matched up against Charm City, and at the moment, I do think Charm City has the stronger record this year. Last year, Montreal was stronger than they are this year. They just have not had a very good year, but they have shown the ability to really lock it down on the track and pull out the win when they really want it. And so I think Montreal's best chance of breaking into the top three in the East is if they can take out Charm City Saturday night.
All right. So the next question I have for you, and I'm going to start with you, John Porter, and it might be similar to the question that we just asked. What do you think the most compelling game of the weekend is going to be?
For me, it's a couple of games. Both of the Philly Roller Girls games, Saturday 8:30 against Texas and then Sunday 3 o'clock against Denver. Philly is, you know, one of those teams that has always been almost at the upper echelon, never quite able to crack that nut. A one-point win against Gotham in 2009. Other than that, they've never really quite gotten to the, you know, the pinnacle of this sport. And I have to wonder which way they're going to go in 2012. They're skating so many of the same girls. Shanita Stretcher, Heavy Flow, Mo Payne are still skating for the Philly Roller Girls. Will this be the year that they finally get over the hump, or is this year that they start to, you know, fade into sort of that second, third tier of the WFTDA rankings? And I think those two games against Texas and Denver are going to tell us a whole lot about where Philly is headed as an organization.
All right, Brad, example.
Well, I'm looking very hard at the Sunday afternoon Rose City versus Gotham game. Rose has actually shown a lot of turnover since last year. Last year, Rose finally made it to the WFTDA championships. They were hungry for it, and they got it. I think the next step is they want to advance on that, and even though they have had a lot of turnover, they've still come out strong this year and really not shown any signs of slowing down. So I think that if any team at ECDX has a chance of taking out Gotham, it's going to be Rose City, and I want to see that bout.
All right, and Tank.
Sorry there. I agree with Brad. I'm really excited for both Gotham games against Rose City and versus Denver, because right now those three teams would have to be ranked in anybody's top five in the world. So depending on who wins those games and what the point spread is on them, that's really going to tell us a lot about going into the tournament season here in the fall as a kind of a midsummer litmus test here at ECDX.
All right. So final question I have for you right now. And you may, again, have answered it already. I think that we've talked a couple of the teams that we're going to want to watch, but are those the teams that we're going to want to watch through the distance of the season? So starting here at ECDX, give me a team you want people to pay attention to throughout the rest of the season. Brad, example.
I'm going to echo a bit of what Koolaid said earlier about AZRD. AZRD not did get those transfers. I believe, though, that one of them, if I'm remembering correctly, Hockey Honey has already moved on for personal reasons, and so that's an additional roster change. But they really showed themselves to be strong at the Wild West Showdown earlier this year. They came very close to beating the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls, and I think since then they've only had more time to gel as a team and to take advantage of that new talent, not only for themselves, but as leadership and taking the rest of the team up a notch. And so I'm really interested to see what Arizona does.
All right, Tank.
Right now, I would be looking at Denver and Rose as the two teams I'm looking at to watch, and even Arizona. I mean, the West is crazy. A lot of the air division, things are pretty cemented. You kind of know who's going to the WFT championships out of it. You know, Texas, Kansas, looking at Minnesota, Windy City. You look at East, you see Gotham, the Charms looking great this year. So you can't say for each region which three are going to go, but then you look to the West, and the West is just nuts. I mean, people one weekend winning huge, next weekend getting beat big. So it's going to be very interesting to see where both Denver and Rose City go coming out of this, depending on if they can pick up wins against Gotham or how close they keep with Gotham, depending on what happens.
All right, and Koolaid.
You know, going back to Gotham, that's the team that I most want to watch, both ECDX and then next month the Star of Texas tournament here in Austin, Texas. It's really amazing to me if you think about it. Gotham has not lost since November 6th of 2010. All of 2011 undefeated. They're undefeated so far in play this year. However, over the next 4 weeks, we're going to see five games by Gotham against Denver, against Rose, against Texas, Windy City, and Bay Area. We're going to have a huge amount of video footage right here on WFTDA.tv on Gotham, and I think we're going to have a really good idea of, is this the year that we can go ahead and start penciling in Gotham for their third championship, or is someone finally going to step up and try to knock them off their pedestal?
All right, gentlemen, very excellent. To sign off, I'm going to have you introduce yourselves, who you call for, and where you currently are, just for the sake of credibility. Start with you, Tank.
I'm Tank. I'm from Cincinnati, Ohio, and I call for the Cincinnati Rollergirls.
Koolaid?
Koolaid. I call for the Texas Roller Girls, and I'm in my living room in Austin, not in lovely Feasterville.
Oh, it's a shame. Brad Example.
Brad Example. I announced for the Denver Roller Dolls, and I'm currently in my office in scenic Boulder, Colorado.
All right. My name is Bam Bam. I am here in Feasterville, and I'm going to be announcing for the Philadelphia Roller Girls. So, Philly, thank you. And we want to thank all of you for tuning in to this. Also, want to remind you, our coverage begins at 5:45 p.m. That is Eastern Time. On WFTDA.tv. It's new and it's exciting. That is the Philly Independence and, of course, Gotham Wall Street Traders. We'll be back at 5:45 WFTDA.tv.